Hello, welcome to Mitch's Rant Time, the show where I talk and you listen. Just a warning, as always, I do get a little vulgar with these videos. There's some adult content, so if you can't handle adult language, off-color, you know, uses of words, might not be the video for you. So anyway, let's get into it. Now the issue I'm going to be talking about is something that's kind of finally dying down, at least I'm hoping it's dying down and finally going to be laid to rest. I like to catch these issues towards the end of their life. I don't like to be caught up in the fray of the bandwagon phase where everybody's jumping on and attacking it. I like to catch it at the end of the tail, the end of the curve, when the dust is settling. A lot of times people jump in haphazard, don't know all the facts, don't know the full story, and they end up sound like assholes. Now, I can see all the signs, see what everyone's come out and said. More than likely, I'm going to get most of the information that is available or will be available. Yeah, sure, there's big reveals about shit and that later, but for the most part, we all understand what happened. I'm not going to get into some of the stupid shit involving it now because there's a lot of dumb crap having to do with things like copyright and that. Speaking of which, just to make sure everyone knows, yes, Charizard is in the shot. It's going to be in this video. It is a shirt I like. Charizard nor Pokemon, neither Charizard nor Pokemon, endorse either side on the opinion I'm about to take. They do not represent a political opinion for Pokemon. They're just something I enjoy. I do not. Neither does the Gadsden flag have a representation in this video other than I wear the flag. I wear the hat as a flag. I wear the flag hat. I'm a little tired, I apologize. But that's the gist of it. Protect my ass. I know people are a little happy with shit like that. Anyway, the issue I'm talking about is that of county clerk, former, not sure. That's one thing I'm not sure about. But I believe she is still in office, county clerk Kim Davis. Now, for those of you who don't know, Kim Davis, as I said before, she's a county clerk, she was elected to office, and she is in hot water, has been in hot water, and still is a little bit in hot water, at least in a media aspect and through, you know, social justice movements. She's in hot water with America right now because she refused to issue marriage licenses to same-sex couples. I believe she was refusing to issue them to all couples for a certain while. The main thing she got in trouble for wasn't so much refusing to do that, but she got in trouble for not following a court order to issue licenses. excuse me. She was refusing it. She got threatened with suit. She was getting sued. She's given a court order stating you need to issue these licenses. She said no. So then they tried to hold her in contempt of court. That's what she got arrested for. And she's been released. Now, when she was charged, when she was sued, when she was charged, she said, she claimed the first. She said, it's my religious right to do what I'm doing. She's trying to say, excuse me, that I'm doing this for God's law. And there's issues with that. There's issues with everything she's done. I'll be going over them step by step. The first thing is she pleaded the first. And a lot of people, presidential candidates, conservatives, even some libertarians, as I like to quote, they're not, are standing by her. And I don't think they understand the Constitution, nor do they understand the First Amendment. Now, the First Amendment is a protection of private citizens from government making laws about or making laws prohibiting exercise of religion. Now, that is for private citizens. That is a restriction on government. The entire Constitution is a line of what the government cannot cross. Now, this would be an issue if County Clerk Kim Davis were having her license refused by either a different county clerk, or if she were the private citizen being refused a license. But it's not that way. She's a member of government. She's an elected official. Taxpayers, the gay couple that went in, probably at least one of those gay couples that went in, more than likely their tax dollars are going to fund her, to pay her salary. So their money is going to her to refuse them. That's part of the problem. That would be like if the county clerk decided to build a Muslim mosque. I'm pretty sure the Christians of that town would be pretty fucking pissed. I know the atheists of that town would be pissed. Atheists don't like government money going to supporting any religion. They feel that's unfair. They feel that's wrong. That's corrupt. So this falls in line with that same thing. It is government money going to support a specific religious view, even if it's one shared by multiple ones. It's still a religious view. It's held in religion. It's a religious value. It is not a moral, with much secular, if any, secular logic. It is one that is based, rooted. I'm going all Shia LaBeouf here. It's rooted in religion and religious law and religious taboos and everything like that. So she's claiming religious freedom. And what needs to be understood is that it is about, as I said, it's Congress shall make no law respecting an establishment of religion or prohibiting the free exercise thereof. Now, as I had said, that means that Congress cannot make a law establishing a religion or concerning religion. Laws about religion are not to be made. Now, a lot of people like to say, well, that means that you can't make a law about when religion does something. No, I have a whole argument about that. I'll do that in another video, of course, as always. But what this is this is not an establishment of religion. This is someone using religion to forward their views or to harm someone. And they're doing it on the behalf of government. And that's a problem. Now, this is where I get upset with the libertarians, because the libertarians should recognize this as government causing harm. And religion, whether it's government using religion or religion using government to cause harm, which is wrong. Libertarians are backing her, of course, because most of these libertarians are anarchist conservatives, and they're fucking assholes. But anyway, enough of the truth, Scotsman. Here's where I'm going to come with this next issue. And then I'll go on my closing. It's kind of a three-part argument. So you would say, okay, well, no, it's roots, it's respect for religion. Someone would say, well, it's still religious freedom. You don't know what you're talking about. Okay, I'll grant you that it's religious freedom. So then, would you support a Muslim county clerk denying women the right to vote? Refusing to issue voter registration papers to a woman. Would you be okay with a Palestinian sheriff, just say parents were Palestinian, they were born in America though, parents migrated, naturalized, and they were born here. Would you appreciate that sheriff, refusing to ever send a patrol to assist a synagogue? How about if a Buddhist sheriff said not to issue CCWs? Regardless of my view on CCWs, whether or not we should even need one to carry is irrelevant. You have to realize you cannot use religion to deny the rights of others, right? You would agree. You'd say, oh, okay, well, you have to make a choice. You either say, yes, they can do that, it's a religious right. Or you say, no, in which you're a hypocrite and you are establishing Christian privilege, which is wrong. But of course, you get back to the circular argument. It's similar to just debating with atheist as well. They say, well, we were founded as a Christian nation. You say, no, we weren't. Nowhere in the in any of our founding documents does it talk about religion. Yes, it may mention a creator in Declaration of Independence, but everything else has been about government and freedom. None of it has been about religion. The mention of the Bible, the mention of Jesus, Moses, the Ten Commandments, Yahweh, Yeshua, which is Jesus. No mention of Israel, no mention of Revelations, no mention of the exit of Exodus, no mention of Genesis, no mention of Adam and Eve, no mention of Jacob, no mention of Joseph, no mention of Isaac, no mention of Abraham, no mention of Noah, no mention of a flood, no mention of anything religious, no mention of Romans, of Pilate, of Judas, of any of the apostles, of Matthew, of Paul, no mention of anyone, of any of that in the Constitution and the Declaration of Independence. The two documents we mostly rely upon for explaining our law, specifically the Constitution. Nowhere in the Constitution does it ever mention religion, with the exception of the First Amendment and Article 6, Section 2, stating that there's to be no religious test for office or public trust. So even after you bring that out, the person arguing with you will typically say, well, look at this passage by Ben Franklin. Look at this passage by George Washington. That's great. What they say in their own time, what they say, even as a president, even as a statesman, is what they say. So are you saying that what Obama says should be law? Whenever he says that we're not a Christian nation, is he then right now, is he correct? What about George Bush and every stupid thing he said? How about every stupid thing that Ford said? What about something that a president like FDR, Truman said? Does everything that a president say become law or have legal precedence? No. And for every time a theocrat comes at me with a quote by Washington, I come back at them with actual documentation that establishes we are not a religious nation. I come back at them with writings of Jefferson. I come back at them with the Jefferson's Virginia state religious freedom law, which was the founding concept that we derived the first clause of the First Amendment from. We very much simplified it. But when you read it, you understand that while he was very religious and definitely did acknowledge a higher power, he believed that everyone's opinion on religion and their own religious beliefs, whether they have one or not, would be protected, and the government shall not impose any religious will on anyone else. So that argument's gone. But let's say that you weren't a hypocrite and said, well, yeah, a Muslim can deny voter registration to a woman. Okay, then, this is where you're wrong. The Ninth Amendment states you cannot do that. The Ninth Amendment reads as follows: the enumeration in this Constitution of certain rights shall not be construed to deny or disparage others retained by the people. Others being other rights explained later in the Constitution, other rights meaning ones that we can legally sue for protections of, sue for infringement upon, sue for damages against. Say maybe the rights you're guaranteed from a marriage license. Now let's explain this too. A marriage license, while it is technically the buying and contracting rights, there are rights within it. There are rights guaranteed and tied to a marriage license. That's what the whole issue of the same-sex marriage movement has been about. It's been about obtaining equal legal status for same-sex couples as heterosexual couples. Because any heterosexual couple that's gone through any financial or health struggles that has divorced, stuck it through, will tell you that there are definitely a lot of rights tied to their marriage license. Had they not had that marriage license, they would not have been able to get through it as easily or get through it in the ways that they did. And the Ninth Amendment, again, no the enumeration in this Constitution of certain rights. So you say the first. That's great. I say the ninth. You cannot use your religious rights. Even, we'll just take away the fact that your government is not supposed to have, you're supposed to be unbiased. You're not supposed to have the power to influence others in such a way. You're not supposed to be able to corrupt your purpose to enforce your beliefs on others. But we'll grant you that. The Constitution states you cannot. She cannot do that. She cannot use her religious freedom to deny others retained by the people. She cannot use her religious freedom to deny voter rights, marriage rights, gun rights, whatever. Cannot be done. It is constitutionally illegal. Illegal. It is unconstitutional. And everyone who is backing this person, who is standing with her, who claims to be a constitutionalist, is a fraud, is an idiot, and needs to pick up their fucking constitution and read it. Put down your Bible, pick up your fucking constitution, and start reading. And because of the fact that so many people are so ignorant of amendments like the Ninth Amendment, parts of the Constitution like Article 4, Article 5, Article 6, they only know the first three. They don't understand anything else in the Constitution. I've decided I'm going to start doing weekly or even maybe semi-weekly readings of the Constitution. It'll be similar to that of what preachers do when they come on to read the Bible and try to explain it. I'll be reading parts of the Constitution. I'll probably start with the first, I don't know what I'll start with. It might be the Bill of Rights. It might be the actual Constitution itself, the first article. But I will be reading it. It's not very long, but I'll be reading it and explaining it. Probably go one article at a time, and then eventually go through each of the Bill of Rights, and then close out with the remaining amendments. Some of the following amendments, the post-Bill of Rights amendments, will probably get their own episodes, but I'll be doing that anyway. Kim Davis is wrong. Those of you who support her are wrong. It is unconstitutional what she has done. It is disenfranchised people. It is wrong. It is illegal. It is immoral and un-American. Yes, this nation may have a majority of Christians. The founders may have all believed in some sort of a Christian-esque higher power. They also fought for freedom from a Christian-controlled theocracy, from a Protestant theocracy, known as the Holy Holy Roman Empire. That was that, but it was the English Empire, which at the center of it was a Protestant church, the Holy Church of England. That was what it was called. I apologize for that little brain fart. It's late or early, depending on how you want to look at it. But yes, they were combating with a empire who was very much influenced by centralized church. We're headed there again. That's not what the founders would have wanted. That's not what freedom is. Iran is where we're headed. Are you about the Iran deal and everything? But that's where we're going. A nation that uses religion to justify the actions of its government. That's not what we're to do. We're better than that. Thank you guys for listening. If you guys like what I said, please leave a like. If you have anything to say, please comment. We'll talk it out. That's how we grow. We may disagree, but yeah, like I said, that's how we grow. And as always, subscribe. We're bringing out more videos. We'll try to post some other stuff other than my boring talk videos. And hope you had a good time. Hope you enjoyed it. So have a good night. Stay cool. Bye.